In 2007 to 2009, we had about 18 gang-related youth murders in South Auckland, right across South
18.
Auckland.
Far
hey, and that was, it was a terrible period. So many of us mobilized and got involved, and long story short, there was a whole bunch of change that we worked for. That mixture of factors from 2007 to 2009 is exactly what I'm seeing in South Auckland, actually in Auckland right now. It's the same mix where you've got a whole bunch of detached, disengaged young people. You've got people that are struggling with a whole bunch of other social issues and social deprivation. I think one of the things that's really changed the game with the gang stuff in South Auckland or in New Zealand is the return of the 501s from Australia. That policy, which I think is an actual, a really unfair policy. And not all, the majority of 501s returnees are integrating into society. They're getting jobs, engaging with their families. But for those that are coming that are still carrying their gang allegiances, it's changed the game. I'll give you a quick story. I'm involved in a whole bunch of street preaching around South Auckland. So we go into the markets and share Christ and have some wonderful time. About 3 weeks ago, about 30 rebels came to where we were. Samoan, unfortunately. And so we started preaching in Samoan. And we started engaging with them in Samoan, talking with them about this kind of stuff. 2 weeks later, firebombs, shootings, barbershops attacked, shootings throughout Mangere, and the community is absolutely worried. Last week, I caught up with some of my friends from the King Cobras, that, you know, some of these guys that I grew up with as, in South Auckland, and we talked about this and their response to what's happening with drugs and gangs, and so I guess what the gang war stuff, I think that is, media's picking up on that, becoming sensational. But actually this, what I'm really worried about is the impact on our communities, on our families. Because when you're shooting up houses, when you're attacking people, when you're burning down businesses, often it's the innocent bystander that's affected. And so I think what I'm seeing in South Auckland today, and especially in my beloved community of Mangere, is that there definitely has been an increase. And really, the increase in violence and attacks and all of this is down to two things: power and money. Hey, and where does the power and money debate come from? It's around drugs. Hey, so that's really what it is. If you want to boil it right down, this is about power and money. This is about the drug game. And so that's why I'm really glad that we as a country didn't legalize cannabis last year.
So then, just to take out what the advocates, those other advocates that we all disagree, we don't want it legalized. What if they turn out and come out and say, well, see, look, you know, the shoot 'em ups, but if we legalized all the drugs, then you would take it away from the gangs. Is that correct?
Yeah. The black market will remain regardless, because those that are underage, those that are, that wouldn't meet the government requirements in that framework, those that don't want to go buy at a government tinny store, still, those are the customers that will still go to the gang. So you won't get rid of the market because it's a money game. What the gangs will do is adjust their market. They'll like, hey, it's all about power and money. Supply and demand, it's all about economics and money, so this is all about money. I think one of the real challenges with the drug game now is there's a whole bunch of advocates that are talking about decriminalization. Hey, they lost the no vote.
They lost the no vote.
So, hey, talk about those who are relentless in their war, in their battles. The left of these advocates are hardcore relentless. Yeah. Hey, so the next battle is decriminalization. We already have decriminalization essentially in our country. We have a pre-charge warning under the law. We've got declining rates of of cannabis prosecutions, convictions, and charges over the last 10 years. So we've got that happening already. So we as a people need to be ready about the decriminalization debate because the numbers are on our side. So this whole debate around cannabis, get rid of cannabis, make it legal, it's going to help the meth stuff, nah, stupid.